Hello, I'm Skid from the Widescreen Gaming Forum, and this is episode 3 of my Dark Souls playthrough. My current death count is 6 according to my tally charts. I had to go through my last episode to find out exactly how many times I died, and I died 4 times in that video, so 2 times before makes 6. So, I'm going to try not to wander around aimlessly as much, so I'm going to not be as cautious, or not be as scared of things that I know will kill me, because things are going to kill me. I will take the advice of the elderly ladies, or the old hags at the start of the game. I will lose all of my souls, over and over again. I just need to get used to that. So, there's a lot of dead things there. Hello. Did I disable? He's an archer, isn't he? Line him up. Ouch! He wasn't an archer. Well, that was a waste of a couple of spells. Not to worry. We already know. Whoa! Actually, I should heal because if they hit me with that thing. That was stupid. Don't want to use my soul arrows because they're running out and I need a campfire. I'm also running out of healing items. So I'm guessing this must be the way I'm going because I'm still facing guys that are around about my level. There's something behind there. Oh yeah, I've got to remember. Okay, let me just check camera settings. That was not where you get the camera settings from. I thought I disabled it. Yeah, it's off. Okay, never mind. Can I get out there? Nope. That's an archer. That is most certainly an archer. Well, I got the feeling this is a trap. There's another guy up there. You come in? Ouch. Now I need to heal because if... There's a dude over there. There's also an item over there. He has an axe or a hammer, some description. I won't waste my soul, hello. Throwing knives might be useful. I need to see how to equip those. Where are they? They're there. Are they an item? They are, they're an item. Ah. I want to remove that from my list. I'll leave the throwing daggers there. I'm desperately low on healing items. I really need to find a campfire. Or a bonfire, or whatever they're called. Well, you can go down there. Let's see, can I see a bonfire from here? That's the question. Bonfire's what I need. He's got a pike. That's a long range weapon. Throw! Visions of head, but visions are quite something. God knows what that's supposed to mean. Okay, so obviously I am supposed to go down. This very much looks like a one-way trip. There's a... Ah. That'll be why. Can I... Is it going to be better to hit him with my staff or with my dagger? My dagger's almost destroyed. Ah! Go! Oh. Dagger at risk. Fortunately, I have a second dagger. And an extra life gem. That is useful. Well, there's fire down there, but I don't think that's a bonfire. I think that's just fire. Okay. So, let's swap out that dagger, because I do have a spare. I'm assuming my weapon will probably be entirely destroyed. If I let it get that low. So that's one way down. Again, I need a bonfire. There's dead things down there. Should I go back to the bonfire? Might be safest to backtrack to the bonfire. We shall plow on. So, run and jump. Hume effigy, that was worth it. Come over here. Is there anything else on these platforms? Doesn't look like it. Oh, scratch that. No, there is. So little room to manoeuvre. And I assume at this point I'm safe to jump down. What's that over there? I'm gonna die. Trying to work something out. That was not fair. Not friendly at all. I want to work out how I'm supposed to level up. I can't figure it out. Well, I'm not going back there because I need to get my items back. Excuse me, sorry, frog in my throat. No, lock on. Right, so let's do this without something interrupting me. Help. Required souls. Required souls to level up. Level up raised attributes. So that just tells me that's how many souls I need to level up. It doesn't tell me how I'm supposed to level up. So what's that then? Soul memory. Souls that once dwelled. Within the flesh will always hear in the main. Is that the total number of souls that I've collected, whether I've lost them or not? God damn you. I don't want to burn a life gem just to get past him. Right. Must be mindful of my life gems. Has that restored... Does resting at a bonfire restore the durability of my weapons? It does. That is useful to know. I did not know that. Oh, if you could fall down, that would be brilliant, because now you're kind of stopping me from getting up. Thank you. And the other two, if you would please. What about you? Because you hurt. Good. Suppose that's one way to cheese them. We won't worry about them for now. We'll go get the archer. There's two people up here, if memory serves. And the best way to kill them was just to pummel them. Oh, it would have been if the wall didn't get in the way this time. I think I already have those. I've got a burning life gem now, I'm almost dead again. Which one was it? I think boots are the ones that I got. Yeah, I already got the boots. Okay, one of them's climbed back up, that's fine. Down to two life gems. Careful not to fall off. Did any one of them climb back up? One of them hasn't climbed back up yet because three fell down. This one over here will get to his feet eventually. Ah, it's him. Three, four. Okay, now where were they in here? There was one around the corner here. There's a couple in here. Ah. Not what I wanted to do. Armor might be one I've not got yet. Ah, it is, but it's going to be worse. Presumably I can't use it, and it's probably not designed for mage anyway. Get this lined up. And again. Thank you. There shouldn't be anything in here because I've already picked up everything in here, so we'll continue on. There's the guy with the arrow at the top. There's a swordman up there. Use the life gem. Do we need to kill him? We don't. So we will ignore him for now. So now I have enough souls to level up, according to that. I'm assuming I must go to someone to level up. Maybe it's that lady. I do have an item that lets me teleport back, but I think it kills me. It makes me drop all of my souls. Bonfire burns me. Belongs to, has the power to travel to a bonfire if it yearns. So there's two guys down here. Two guys down there. The souls I lost are over there. I could just leg it to the souls and then try and teleport back. But without knowing whether or not... I'm sure there's an item that I can use that will... I need to make sure that's not the item I think it is. Because I remember that there is an item I can use, but it makes me drop all of my souls. Dark Souls induces death, fraternity. Ah! That's the item. So that's a safe teleport, that's a not safe teleport. Wrong one. So let's put that there. Let's just double check what all some of these other items do as well. So that one, online play, I don't want to use. Symbol of farewell that's been passed down from Earth. This crystal sends phantoms back to their homes or sends you back to yours. Yeah, so that's for online play as well, so they're not something I need to use. Equipment. Let's swap out this dagger for this dagger. Where else were they? There's one down there, I can see, but I can't hit him. No! Really? That distance kills me. Well, there goes 2,000 souls. You will lose your souls over and over and over again. Alright, sod it. I'm going to consider those lost. I'm changing tactics. Let's collect enough souls to level and then see if we can level. So I need 800 to level. Ignore that guy for now, too. Kill him. Yeah, we'll cheese this again. Two down. I only need one left up there. I've got to stop double tapping when I just want a chain hit. There's something I do in Monster Hunter as well. I tap the button to ensure that it went through, but in this it does a heavy attack, which leaves you vulnerable, which is not good. Ooh, close. 500 souls. Well, at least this is good practice. 30 minutes in and I'm still no further on than I was before. Matter of learning the game, getting used to it. Okay. No, I'm not going to try and kill him till I've leveled up. You're the guy that's about to wake up, aren't you? And then there's the guy with the axe here. That was the guy with the axe, so this guy. That's not enough. Am I gonna have to burn my life gem more? No, in fact I don't. Just fire. One more. Is that enough? That might be enough. That's enough. Sod getting my 1,000 back. They should they still be there? Actually, that's something I'll be interested to know. I'm going to end up coming back this way anyway. But if I teleport away from here and then teleport back, does the last place where I died and all my souls are still stay there? That's what I want to know. I think it should do. My understanding is that they probably should do. So, rest of the bonfire, travel back to there.
Bearer of the curse. Seek souls. larger, more powerful souls. Seek the king. That is the only way. Lest this land swallow you whole, as it has so many others.
I can level up! Oh, now this is problematic. I don't know how I'm supposed to build it. Ah, that's useful. Obviously, intelligence is going to be magical damage. Can I get help? Help, yes, thank you. Magical attack bonus. Fire attack bonus. Lightning attack bonus. Are they not magic attacks? Cast speed. Poison attacks. Dark attacks. So I'm guessing these... Maybe they're all different kinds of magic. It's really hard to tell. I know that the spell I'm using is basic, is just a basic magic attack, so... Magic defense... Right. Attack strength, attack distance. Power to inflict damage with physical attacks improves with dexterity. To inflict damage with them. So what determines which is used? Does it just use the highest? Slots. Attunement slots. Each slot allows attunement of one spell. Can be increased by raising attunement. Equipment load. Stamina. Health. The ability to withstand impact of attacks. Boosts ease of evasion of other actions and other actions. And they're all resistance, so they're status effects. Poison, bleed, petrify, and curse. And their defense. Four types of elements and physical and magical. In fact, no. There's four types of elements. So magical, fire, lightning, and dark. The question is, are those all classified as magical attacks? And then physical defense. That's damage with the right weapon, damage with the left weapon. Can I cancel this? I have a short sword. I want to be able to equip it. No. Current durability, total reduction. For attack. Pose damage. Oops. What I need to know is what I require to equip it. So they're all the defences on the left-hand side. Attack, slash. There must be a way to know. Type of weapon, weapon categorised by physical specifications. Counter strength, level of the counter damage inflicted on attacking enemies.
Bearer of the curse. Seek souls. Larger, more.
Sorry.
Bearer of the curse. Less.
I wanted to just shut up, but the E button didn't work. Okay. So, how many points do I have? So each level gives you 1 point. Well, because I'm going to be focusing on evading, I would like more dexterity, and I'm not so bothered about strength, but... Again, I don't know which is required for... That gives me a slot for an extra spell, but I don't have a second spell. So many choices, so little information. So it obviously wants me to focus on intelligence and attunement. Those are obviously my two key stats. I picked a sorcerer, which makes sense. So they're the two sorcerer stats. If I'm going for battle mage, then I also need to have stats capable of using physical weapons properly. Attunement actually increases agility. If I had those 2,000 souls, I could level up twice. Okay, we'll increase dexterity slightly. In fact, dexterity doesn't actually increase agility. Increases physical defense, dexterity attack, poison and bleed. It's going to be 5 minutes of me sitting here trying to work this stuff out. I'm not going to look up a guide. Equipment load. I'm nowhere near my equipment load, so vitality is no use to me. Yeah, I think attack dexterity. I'll put an extra point in that. I don't have any extra spells, so it makes no odds to there. Do I actually have a flask shard? No, that's a flask. Replenish a bonfire. Do I have a flask shard? Guess not. Right. Let's see if that slight increase allows me to equip that without a detriment. It does! Oh, there's the requirements! They're down here. So to equip that, I actually need a dexterity of 10. Is it 10? In fact, help. Required attribute strength. Strength required to equip this item. Required attribute dexterity. Dexterity required to equip this item. So I'm actually slightly less, but I think that's not as high a negative as it was. Broken thief sword. Do I need both or just one? Unable to use with effective. Yeah, I need both. So the daggers are still going to be higher damage. However, the broken straight sword. Nope. Attunement bonus strength. Influence of the strength on physical attack. There we go. Okay, so yeah, I'm going to need to increase strength as well as that. Which is basically, if I'm going to have to go down both trees, it's going to gimp me slightly. But that's fine. I accept that. So that's the staff that, yeah, I can't use that yet. Ooh. Do I just need one or both? Yeah, you do need both. So yeah, it looks like I'm going to have to level up strength if I want to use this build properly. However, that at least now can be used. So, I mentioned in my last video, and I will end my video after this, that there were some little annoying buggers on this map. I wonder what's down there. There's some little annoying buggers on this map. They're around here. There's three of them. One of them's already found me. Here they come. Whatever the hell these things are supposed to be. The problem is, they're small, and you can't really hit them that hard. I probably spent about 5 minutes chasing around trying to kill these buggers. Have a really high physical defense, or am I just not doing that much damage? Simple way to check. Switch to the dagger, because I know the dagger does damage, but yeah, no, they do, they just have high physical defense. But yeah, they're annoying little buggers, and you'll see lots of little blood stains all over the place. All over this place, and you can bet your life they'd probably be caused by these guys. Unfortunate that I'm a mage. But yeah. Okay, let's see if we can retrieve our souls. Hang on, that's 45 minutes. Let's see if I can... No, actually no. Then... What happens if you burn it, though? I know if I use it, it restores my humanity, and if... Let's travel back to here. Okay, so, yeah. The human effigy, as I said, I'm a holo. Let me take my... head off, or helm off, hood off, if I can unequip it. How do I unequip it? Remove. So yeah, I'm holified. So that's what I look like when I'm a holo. Now, if you die while you're a holo, then if you see my health bar, the bar actually extends beyond that little cap on it. And the reason for that is that I've died while I was a holo. And if I want to get that health back, I have to use a effigy. But also, like I said, using the effigy also reduces the chance of your world being invaded. So there's that as well. Now, what we shall do is we shall clear out this area here. We won't go up there, and I'll end the video there. Because I want to know whether this sword... Or how much better this sword actually is. That's not bad. Ah, no, lock onto him. Yeah, so that's definitely better. I'm dealing more damage with that, so I guess grinding is going to be the next thing to do. We'll see if we can't get those 1,000 or that 1,000 back. By the time I get there, that will give me another 1,000 anyway. So if I can get it back, that'll give me 2,000, which is an extra 2 levels, so hopefully I'll be able to upgrade my strength so I can start using swords properly, along with my magical weapons. So yeah, we'll see how it goes. Right, so yeah, we'll leave that video there, and I will immediately start recording the next one after this one. So, I entirely forgot to keep track of how many times I died. I've died twice, haven't I? Yeah. Almost certain I've died twice, but I will watch the video back to check it, because I died once when I lost those, the 2,000. And then I died again when I had 1,000, trying to get the 2,000 back, and then I abandoned the attempt, and I've not died since. So that didn't go as bad as it did last time, but yeah, Dark Souls, wonderful. Right, we'll leave it there. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you next time.